Let's go back to Namibia and take a look at how that economy has been performing. And if we begin by taking a look at the overall index of the Namibian market, in fact, we can see that today that market was slightly in the black, 97.21. Of course, there are a lot of South African companies that are listed on the Namibian exchange. That Namibia, the other Namibian index also just flat on the day, 0.02%. On the currency front, the Namibian dollar, which we know is tied at the hip with the South African rand, slightly weaker today, 0.9%, 9.2590 against the dollar. Let's go over now to the NBC studios in Windhoek, where we join Patrick Britz, he's the economist at Capricorn Asset Management. Patrick, thanks for your time. Let's talk about these GDP numbers that are coming tomorrow. I had a chat earlier. I'm hoping that you'd have listened to the conversation that I had with Arthur Camp, where he was talking about the global backdrop, which of course has not been the rosiest and has been putting pressure on the Namibian market. From where you stand, what are you expecting in terms of the numbers that are coming up for GDP tomorrow?
Well, luckily we had some insight as the fourth quarter GDP figures were released last week by the Namibian Statistics Agency, showing improvement of 4.3, rather growth of 4.3 in the Namibian economy. This is significantly better than the contraction of 3.7% seen in the third quarter. Quarterly statistics here tend to be quite volatile given the small scale of the Namibian economy, so we can't really read into that too much. But looking at the two largest sectors, which is namely mining and agriculture, we saw an expansion of 47% in the mining industry and 21% in the agricultural industry. So this is way above what was expected. And as such, we are revising our growth figure which is set to be released tomorrow, up to high as 5.3%. And comparing that to consensus earlier was 4.5%, which was largely expected in the market.
So, in terms of your drivers and the outlook for the rest of the year, and as I said, you know, given the global environment that we're talking about and the kind of pressures that we've seen here in the larger economy, South Africa, do you think you'd have to look at your numbers for the rest of the year and tweak them again, perhaps higher, as you're suggesting?
Possibly not higher, because we do see that if you look at mining, for instance, we're at maximum capacity when it comes to the diamond mining. We came off quite a low base in 2011. There were strikes across most of the sectors. So we saw a massive improvement in 2012 from 2011. Luckily in Namibia, as the guest before mentioned, that we have quite a strong domestic economy as well, which is partially shielding most of the cold headwinds coming from Europe. But we are going to have to look at our figures again, no doubt. And seeing as though we had a particularly good year in terms of growth, or what we're expecting for 2012, we might not see that much of an improvement. But at the same time, the consensus is that the global growth picture is rather bottoming out, and we should see some pickup in export demands. More particularly uranium prices moving ahead. I think they're at a six-year low at just over $40 a pound. So again, that's a massive part of the Namibian economy, and we hope to see a pickup in uranium prices, which will obviously translate into a higher GDP reading going forward.
Yeah, so let's look at some of the leading indicators. So we had the trade statistics coming through last week, and there we had the trade deficit a little bit widening. What's your outlook for Namibia's trade position?
I think an important thing to remember is the national budget was just announced, the Minister of Finance rather, announced a broad tax cut across the taxpaying population. Obviously, this is going to free up a lot of disposable income, which would be useful, and obviously is going to contribute to the already high levels of domestic activity and domestic demand in the economy. But at the same time, one must remember that the marginal propensity to save in Namibia is very, very low. And with this in mind, most of the goods that are sold in Namibia, it's 70% of that is imported. So there's going to be a massive demand for imported goods going forward. So this newfound disposable income is most likely going to fuel a larger import bill, and of course that coupled with a depreciating exchange rate that we've seen over the last few months is only leading in one direction, and that's an expansion of our trade deficit.
Yeah, but I suppose here in South Africa they would be saying we wish Namibia's trade figures with us were much bigger than they are, and therefore would be getting the benefit of the increase in imports. But talk to a little bit about the tax relief. I mean, that was quite innovative. As Arthur was mentioning, you have government finances under pressure, but the government has actually taken the latitude and has had the room within which to move a little bit around its revenue collection space and reduced interest. Taxes.
Yes, luckily we have been in the position compared to most countries, very lucky indeed, that we've had more room for fiscal expansion, at the same time a bit of easing of the tax breaks. But at the same time, one must look at a comparison to other countries in the region, and Namibian income tax rates have been a lot higher than the likes of Botswana and South Africa. So one would argue that this is more of a correction than anything else, and it's about time, or the tax break was long overdue.